do you do actual little explanations of, so like short little clips, you know, like 3 minutes, and just talk about what we're doing. Yeah, so, okay. I'm glad you're all here, and today's class is Monday's class. It will be the massage aspect of the joints and glands, which we call Abhyanga, and that's a Sanskrit word. And literally Abhi is referring to the sense of I, like the ego, I, our sense of self, like when you refer to yourself as I, Jasper. This is Abhi. So an Anga is limb, like this is an Anga, this is an Anga. So Abhyanga is self limb, and it's a practice of self possession, meaning to really come into the awareness of our body through just, you know, imaging it, touching it, massaging it, and helping the energy come through.
So when we get to the website, there'll be cues as to which one I can choose.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, just like that. Just like if I say, you know, chair massage or Abhyanga.
Or use words.
Absolutely. And it's just exactly like this. Like you'll feel like you're right here. So please begin today by sitting tall and arranging your spine so that you are as straight as possible without exceeding your capacity, and come into the feeling sense of the breath flowing in both nostrils. Feeling of the warmth of the breath coming in the nostrils maybe feels a little cool at first, maybe a little dry. And notice the way that breath travels up the nostrils, and you feel it as it warms and moves into the space behind the eyes. And you feel the breath moving in the navel and abdomen region of your body. You feel the rib cage being expanded by the in-breath and the relaxation on the out-breath. And breathe naturally. And so I begin with a little invocation which my teacher wrote in Sanskrit to acknowledge the intuitive wisdom that has come down through the unbroken succession of teachers, men and women over many centuries who have learned these practices and continued to teach them.
Hiranyagarbha Dharata Sheshavyasa Dimadhyama Swami Shri
This wave of the peacefulness of the breath, as the breath moves in through the nostrils and into the mind body, we gradually transition to the first of our practices this morning. And this is where, if you are wearing glasses, you may wish to simply remove your glasses and put them in a pocket, or just to the side, cross your knee, and bring your awareness to the base of your thumbs and raise those to your forehead where your nose bridge joins the eyebrow ridge. And then smooth, using the base of the thumbs, smooth across the forehead to either side. When you get to your temples, massage your temples with making circles there. And begin again in the middle of the forehead with the base of your thumbs, the broad surfaces, and smooth across the frontalis bone of your forehead to either side, and make a circle at the temples. Yet a third time, bring the base of the thumbs to where your hairline joins your scalp and your forehead, and smooth across the dome of the forehead with your base of your thumbs, that broad surface. You press fairly hard, gentle but firm, and make a circle at the temples when you get there. Then lower your arms just for a moment. Breathe. Relax any tension and bring the awareness to your thumb and your index fingers, and make a little window between your thumb and your index fingers. Hold them in front of your face for a moment, and then bring them to your eyebrow ridge where your nose ridge joins the eyebrow, and massage your eyebrows with your thumb and your index finger, feeling the upper rim of your eye socket and working your way across the top of each orbit over to the sides and the temples. Make a circle there with your fingertips, massaging that muscle, the temporalis muscle, this big flat muscle on the side of your head where we call our temples are. And we come back to the middle of the eyebrow with the thumb and the index finger, and we massage again, massaging and feeling the upper rim of your eye socket. Noticing as you massage your eyebrow, the condition of your spine, letting the breath keep the spine nice and tall so that you have good energy flow along the spine as you do these self-massage practices. When you've completed massaging the temples, for a third time, begin in the middle of the forehead, in the middle of the eyebrows, rather, where the nose bridge joins, and you massage. You can use slightly different techniques with your thumb and your index finger each time. Sometimes you are massaging the tissues a little bit like you were making miniature bread dough. And at other times, maybe you're using kind of a press and release technique where you press on the bone through the tissues and then release with your thumb and your index fingers. You work your way from the middle of the forehead where your nose bridge joins the eyebrow ridge You work your way across the top of the eye sockets to the sides, and when you get to the temples, you massage your temples with the tips of your fingers. And here again, you can use a firm but gentle pressure to make circles there. And when you need to, or at this moment, just lower your arms and let them rest while you collect your breath. There, that's better. I think my microphone was getting a little out of place. Okay, so sitting tall, just letting the spine be nice and wrinkle-free, and letting the breath run up and down the spine, giving a prana bath to the spine, an energy bath. And then bring the awareness to the index fingers and bring those up so that you can lay them alongside your nose, so they're resting on the lower rim of your eye socket right next to your nose. And I like to press on that lower rim of the eye socket without pressing on the eyeballs. I press with my index fingers right underneath the eyes on the lower rim of the eye socket. I press and I release, and then I move the finger a little farther to either side, pressing and releasing each time, noticing the warmth of my fingers. They feel really warm today. And when I get over to the temples, make a circle with the fingers on the temple, massaging that big flat muscle there. And begin again, right next to the nose, with the index fingers pressing on the lower rim of the eye socket. Press, release, press, and release, press, and release, press, and release. You keep moving your fingers each time a little to either side, working your way around the lower rim, over to the sides of the eye socket, and at the temples, you make that circle with your fingertips. And then lower your arms to rest for a moment. Sometimes they get a little tired from holding them up for these practices, but that's part of our exercise. And next, we bring the base of the thumbs against the base of the nose where the nostrils are, so that you can mush the nostrils with the base of your thumbs, and then use the base of your thumbs to massage your cheek muscles. Work your way down underneath the cheekbones on either side, and then up along the sides of the cheeks, the sides of the face, up towards the ears. And maybe you can use your fingertips to massage the area of your jaw just in front of your ears. Open your jaw and feel that jaw joint. And use your fingertips to kind of just massage over the hinge point there. Can be really sensitive, so be aware of that. And then lower the arms. Lower the arms, yeah, there we go. Okay, get this apparatus here so that it hooks around my ears. Keep falling off. Okay, let's do that one more time. Bring the base of the thumbs to the base of the nose, the nostrils, and massage those nostrils with the base of the thumbs and the cheek muscles underneath the cheeks and to the sides, and then work your way up along the sides of the jaw towards the ears. Jaw joint, open the jaw, close, open, and massage those muscles just in front of the ears. It actually feels good to kind of close your ears a little bit, like by pressing on the front of your face, you just kind of massage the ear canal there, and then just below the base of the ears, you can move your head a little side to side to get onto the base of the skull with your fingertips, just behind your ears, there, where your hairline is. arms again. Let the breath arrange your spine nice and tall. And now we continue with the fingertips on the upper lip, just below the nostrils, just massaging where the teeth go into the gums. You're massaging the outside of your lip, so you're not sticking your fingers in your mouth, but you're just massaging where the teeth go into the gums through your lip. And you work your way along your teeth, back towards the jaw. And as you get towards the jaw, you notice, like, if I was to make myself smile, I would, yeah, that's it, yeah, sure. This kind of pulling of that muscle there. And you can use your thumb and your finger to massage that vertical band of muscle that you feel. Just run your fingers back and forth across it. And a very good massage. It really makes the face relax. And you probably notice that you're generating some saliva in your mouth as you massage the parotid glands there. So, okay, good. If you're wearing glasses, now's a good time. You can put your glasses back on if you feel like it, or just leave them off. And we continue with the lower portion of the face, the jaw. So the tip of the chin, use your thumb and your fingers to massage the lower teeth where they go into the gums, and use your thumb to massage underneath the jaw, the edge of the jaw. Use a kind of a stroking motion with the thumbs to move over where if you take the thumb and you kind of move along from the back towards the tip, and the other way too, both directions. It's very soothing, and you can feel the edge of the bone, of your jawbone there. Yeah, it's usually pretty, you know, it's sort of a sharp feeling. The bone's kind of sharp. And you can feel the corners of the jaw as well. So right where you get to that corner, if you take your thumb and your fingers and you kind of go around that part of the jaw, it's very soothing. And your fingers are able to kind of just circle around there and increase the circulation. Very good. Okay. So lower your arms and just reflect for a moment. We have all five nerves, sensory faculties in our faces, in our heads. We have our eyes, our ears, our nose, our taste buds, and our feeling sense. So we have a lot of neurons, sensory neurons there. So this massage begins at the head and the face. And just simply through this massage, we can feel better. We can start to feel the release of endorphins and relaxation. We increase our saliva, which helps with our digestion. And we're massaging the area around our thyroid gland, which is very important.